Thousands of retired Ohio teachers will know tomorrow if they will get a cost of living increase that they've been denied for 7 years after the promised annual hike was eliminated by the state teachers' retirement system. The STRS board will vote on a one-time increase for retirees, but angry retired teachers and even some board members say it's not enough. After 7 years of stagnant pension pay, the proposal is for a one-time cost of living increase of 2%.
Is that adequate? Is it enough? And will it make teachers happy?
I think the answer to all of those questions is no. It's not enough. It's really just an insult. That's not what people were promised. And it is not something that will allow teachers to live in and have a dignified retirement.
Economist Dr. Rudy Fichtenbaum is at odds with most other members of the STRS board, especially after he published a scathing report accusing investment staff members of manipulating investment benchmarks to guarantee hefty bonuses.
To show you how absurd the whole system is that even if you're losing money, and even if the pension was headed for insolvency, as long as they were going down more slowly than the benchmarks, they would still be getting bonuses.
But other board members and staff at STRS say Dr. Fichtenbaum is simply wrong.
The benchmarks are set in compliance with the Global Investment Performance Standards. The GIPS compliance is the gold standard, and the accusations that were made earlier this month by our board member were based on miscalculations and a misapplication of the policy.
However the bonuses are calculated, they are remarkably high. In one case, a $294,000 income was nearly doubled by a $293,000 bonus.
When you see bonuses like that, don't you understand why that would anger teachers who can't get a cost of living increase?
Yes, it is. It's understandable why they might be a little bit confused by that. But the investment compensation is set by the board, and they have done numerous compensation studies to make sure that we are compensating people fairly based on the work that they do.
Trenoff says STRS is still recovering from the 2008 recession, but its investments are getting healthy again. Still, there is no plan to restore the promised annual cost of living hike.
That's just kind of a bait and switch. It's lying to people.
Hopefully we're on a positive track now where we can look to add to that in future years.
The board will also vote tomorrow on a plan to roll back by 1% how much active teachers have to pay into the pension system. Right now, it's 14% of their annual income, compared to about 6% for those who pay into Social Security.